Good afternoon and thanks for joining us right here on Midday Kentucky, which is going to be a rocky show, my friends.
Yeah, we have a lot going on today.
I'm very excited about
today. I'm excited to see these step moves that you have in the K-Games.
I just want to tell you, remember a few weeks ago when I went to my very first UK basketball game? Mm-hmm. I actually said UK baseball game, but I did mean to say basketball game a few weeks ago. And I have to say, I absolutely loved the cheerleaders and found these guys who were stepping on the night. I'd never heard of stepping. I thought they were amazing, and I wanted to bring them in as well.
Glad to have them.
It was
on
fantastic.
A Friday of all things,
hey,
too.
Buddy, very quickly, I want to ask you, driving to work this morning, I saw some snow.
A couple flakes
just
out there.
Just a little flaky down on my car.
Yeah, we're even still seeing some flakes from time to time. 40s out there today. We're going to warm things up for your weekend.
Dude.
Nice and mild, though.
Like what?
We went from 70 to 40.
Yeah.
I know. Absolutely crazy. Listen, I really thought this was a beautiful video. Let me intro it, and then we'll kick off our day with a feel-good video. How does that sound? Well, a simple but effective ad campaign is promoting gender equality in the best way by stating it as an obvious matter of fact. Procter & Gamble has debuted its latest ad just in time for Women's History Month. Take a look, everyone. Absolutely love this. Now, of course, goes on a little bit longer, but it's a few days shy of International Women's Day. Mm-hmm. The P&G slogan is, we see equal, and it makes the smart argument that behaviours activates the emotions that we would normally associate with men, and women aren't actually gendered. Mm-hmm. They're all a social construct.
Mm-hmm.
You guys, I asked you both to watch the video before the show.
I did.
What did you think?
First, great clips that they pulled.
Aren't they beautiful?
Really, I remember seeing the diaper one. That might be my favorite. I know the struggle there.
I'm sure a few mothers have dry-reached as well. Let's be real.
For sure.
But I like the message, too. I think it really is what they're trying to get across. It's like, guys can do this, girls can do that, we can all do it together. We're all chipping in.
And it doesn't matter whether you're a guy or a girl. It's like everyone chips in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I really like it. I like at the end how they said equal pay doesn't care who earns it.
Exactly.
And then that's when they end with their logo. So that was really well done.
I like it. Is it bad if I tell you I had a bit of a cry?
And a little.
Watching it?
Feeling it.
I had a little flurry.
The music.
A little flurry.
The music in the background, really, that's what puts it over the line.
Yeah, I think it was the music. And also, I think, you know, we often talk about here on the show gender equality and man's job versus women's job versus pay, who earns what, single, married. Like, I think that's something that we all like to talk about. But when you see that, it does, again, make you think, why don't we just let everything go and just let people be people?
I wish,
Don't you agree?
Well, that's why I like messages like this coming out
It makes you feel good.
We've come so far since the old-fashioned days.
Back on to a little bit more fun. I know that was probably a little bit deep for you. I want to talk to you a little bit about dodgeball. I don't even know what dodgeball is.
Okay, to clarify, it's kind of like there's two teams, and you're throwing balls at each other, and if you get hit with the ball, you're out. If you catch a ball, you go back in, or a teammate comes back in.
Okay.
So they didn't play this
team.
Well, we have a video to explain it to you.
Yeah. So if you haven't seen it, so the balls start in the middle.
Famous
you
movie.
You run to the middle.
Oh, I think I've seen this movie.
It's entertaining. It's a more lighthearted look at the whole thing. And then see, they start throwing balls at each other, and
it's a bit.
Yeah. See, so it could
that's
get
the point. You have
a
to
little,
hit the people.
A little.
That's
violent.
A little rough.
So.
Oh.
What the
oh, this is a movie though, people.
No, this is how the game is.
This is an exaggeration of what dodgeball really is. But the question is now, this has been discussed a lot lately, should our kids in elementary and middle school be allowed to play dodgeball or other competitive sports? So when I was a kid growing up, when I walked in the gym and you saw the red foam balls, I got excited. I love dodgeball. But there's also the kids that don't enjoy dodgeball so much.
That
maybe
is some
of the more
me.
I thought you were more excited about the balance beam.
Think that should be in there.
You left it open there, that's why.
So not just dodgeball, but you know, should we be forcing kids? Should they have the option? I mean, physical education these days, it's a stressful time for kids, girls.
Yeah, and we were talking about that in our pre-show meeting. That was like some horrific memories of mine in middle school. I was painfully shy, and when you would go to gym class and these types of games were required, it would ruin my entire day and my psyche for the week. I was so embarrassed to see the kids later because I couldn't play. And you couldn't play
or you didn't want to play is a different thing.
I was like paralyzed in fear, of being hit by the ball. I think that they should be playing games, and everyone should be required to do some physical activity. But I think games like this, I think, yes, have them, but I do think they should be optional. And there should be another game you could play. I believe in physical activity, but for me, that's a little violent to force kids to do. And I just remember being terrified.
But and I know firsthand that physical education has changed drastically since I was in school versus what they do now. My mother was an educator for many years, taught young kids. And she says, you know, these kids are out there, but what they do in PE is a lot different than what you did. You know, it's more interactive. It's more just getting them to move and stuff, where we had the option, you know, if you wanted to be a bully and hit the kid shaking in the corner, you could just tee off on him.
I think we should not replace physical education with anything.
100%.
It's, you know, we have a very bad case of obesity here in America. And I just also want to say, I'm not just saying America, Australia is now 60% obese now as well. But I remember back at school, we had things like show jumping, surfing, you know, really sports that were very active. Of course, we had football and all those, but not dodgeball. There was nothing that really, if I remember correctly, that was hitting anyone like that.
Yeah, like I like the days where we'd play tennis or even like a flag football game. And I agree, like we're seeing obesity rates that are so high. But that's another reason why we should be having our kids do something they enjoy, not something that alienates half the kids. So then they associate gym class or physical activity
with something
negative.
And that falls on the educator too. Finding a way that gets everyone moving, accomplishes that part of it. And also, you know, something that's fun. And I think that's a hard thing to accomplish in this day and age. But dodgeball should be an option for the kids that want to play. I'm going to stress that enough.
But you're basically saying, should they be forced to play dodgeball or not?
Because it was the whole class. There wasn't, I want to sit out. It's like, no, you're going to do this because...
I don't think you should force any student to do something that they don't necessarily believe
in. But
they're
not doing their job.
Yes, but you can also say, okay, you don't want to play dodgeball. Okay, go do 10 laps.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, what physical activity would you like to do?
I don't want to do anything. That's
well, then you lose grades, or I don't know how it works here in America. Mm-hmm. If you don't do a certain activity at our schools in Australia, you lose grades. Mm-hmm. Like, so you have to do something, you know. And I think that's the important thing: get up and move.
I'm going to steal your line here. I want to see what people at home think about this topic.
Where would you like them to go and tell
us? Go to our Facebook page, Monday, Kentucky.
Aw, Eric, look at you doing that.
I've been sitting
promo.
Next to you since November. I got it figured out.
I'm pleased. I like it. Yeah. Hey, I want to. This is a very interesting topic that you are bringing up. And because I have some girlfriends in Australia in the media who have chosen not to have children, and they have been slammed in the media.
And that's just an interesting study I saw online today. It's from IUPUI in Indiana. And this was a study just getting into the feelings toward people who choose to be child-free as adults. And a lot of the research, they're saying this could be a shift in the mindset of millennials. More people are choosing maybe that's not the life for them. But what was interesting about this study is they found people don't only find it odd or an atypical thing to do. They actually find it morally wrong more times than not to choose not to have children. They feel like it is your moral imperative to have children and have a family. And if you're not doing that, people are thinking there's something morally wrong or you're selfish or things like that. So I kind of wanted, what do you guys think? And you know, I'm 27 and I don't know if that's
You've
the life
You've come down
for
an
me.
Age since so last week.
I've always been 27.
she's about to go up though soon.
I had Botox last week for the first time. So I will say I was like 37, now I'm back to 27.
What I put you both through is absolutely crazy.
Yeah, you'll see the segment coming up, but Troy set me up with it. But
back to this, look.
But back to that, I think if you openly talk to people and say, I'm not sure if that is for me, I hope it is, or, and then people are kind of shocked, I'll find that, or...
I look at it like this. There's some women who say they choose not to have children, take it upon themselves not to tell the whole world that they couldn't conceive. Yeah. And that's their right.
Right.
And
I think it's a very private
issue.
It is
no one's business whether a woman chooses to or to have a child or not to have a child. I think nowadays that the society is allowing women to make choices.
Yeah.
Okay. No one should be judging them on whether that choice is right for them.
But Troy,
Yeah, go on.
But what's interesting about this study is they said the outrage, the moral outrage, is also almost equally projected on men choosing not to have children.
Hmm.
So what do you think at a certain age?
Could you imagine me with a child? I'm the most selfish man in the world.
That's true.
I'm not sure what I'd have to give up first. I do know that if I had a child, I'd probably have to have a team of nannies. And
yeah. Mm-hmm.
I couldn't do it all.
But don't you think sometimes that is the almost selfless thing to do? If you know that it's not the lifestyle for you and you couldn't devote your all to a child, that you're making the right choice not to do that.
And there's so many arguments to that,
too. What do you think?
I mean, I think some of the more old-fashioned people will look at you and be like, why do you not want kids? It could be personal preference. I don't want kids. Or selfish reasons, either your work. If you can't give them the best upbringing for financial reasons or just other commitments, you know, is it worth it?
No, and I think that's the key point there. You said more about financial. Here's the thing. Mm-hmm. Now, if you're depending on your faith and the path that you choose in life, you know, I come from a Mormon state in Utah for 3 years. They're encouraged to have children.
Right.
And more, whether you can afford it or not. But the church will take care of you. Unfortunately, I personally believe that if you want to have 3 or 4 children and you cannot financially afford to have them, mm-hmm. are you doing a disservice to you and your family? I don't know.
Right.
I think that if you can afford to have 2, because of what you're saying is, you know, if you can have the children and choose to have them and give everyone a great life, how mm-hmm. wonderful is that?
Absolutely.
Doesn't mean people who don't have money or who can't afford to give their children the better things in life are any less better parents.
Right.
That's not what I'm saying. But I'm saying is that you have a choice in life on what you want to do as an adult. Mm-hmm. And if you want to bring children into the world, then that's your choice. And you know that you have a responsibility, probably not just for the next 18 years, but for the rest of your life.
And
that's why I don't judge someone who's 45 or whatever, and you mm-hmm. are married and don't have children. I think people associate marriage with then you must have a child. And the study talked a lot about that. People are outraged that married couples without children. And I think you don't have to want kids mm-hmm. to get married. You can want a life partner.
I think that's an old-fashioned theory, and I think a lot of people are still set in the ways. Troy, you come from a pretty big family.
Very big.
My dad is the oldest of 7, so that was the norm. The average household size has shrunk so much, too. Most having one or two.
Yeah.
But you don't see the...
So
very
how do you think your family
you
would
feel?
And I know you do want a family, but mm-hmm. if you chose not to have kids, what do you think your family's reaction would be?
I think there would be some pressure for mom and dad just for the, you know, we want grandkids.
Okay.
I know my brother and his wife are still kind of on the fence. I know my sister will have a kid probably before my brother. And she's younger, much younger, too.
All right.
Hey, I just want to quickly tell you about, we just had a post.
What have they got?
Someone messaged you, my friend.
Someone sent Eric a message.
Leslie Wayman, I should say. She said, I hated PE for reasons. Oh, I'm so sorry. I hope it is Leslie. As in Leslie as in a girl or a guy. Was that a guy spelling?
I can't
or
see.
L-E-S-L-I-E.
But anyways.
I hated PE for reasons just like dodgeball. No desire to hit or be hit. Should be one of many options, as should be dressing out, optional.
Okay.
Yes, that's a big thing we talked about.
I don't know what dressing out is.
They force you to wear a gym uniform. And that's so funny. I was telling you about this. Mm-hmm. I was horrified in 6th grade when you had to wear these shorts for gym class. And it's when, like, girls start to have, you know, like, shave your legs or whatever. And my parents wouldn't let me. And I was horrified that I had to wear the shorts and people would make fun of me that
you tell me you didn't have hairy legs.
I mean, I was like 12.
Oh, Katie!
I was like 12 years old. So I'm already horrified to be in the outfit. And then, Leslie, I totally relate. Then you're cowering in the corner getting hit by balls.
She's had a very tough life, everyone.
It's bad.